Good morning, everybody. I'm Lewis Munns, President of Regis. Welcome you to our coffee and chemistry talk. We have plenty of talks, and if you look on our website, you're even on YouTube. I have a little promotion of our company. We're a company that takes molecules from development up through the clinic to commercial, and we do all the associated analytical validation and purity work along with that for your filing documents to the Drug Master File. We have really good fortune to have Mike Anisfeld here as a speaker. Mike has 35 years in the pharmaceutical industry in production, quality, and technical transfer. Mike was educated in the UK and is actually a qualified person in the UK. So some of our products are released in Europe by QPs, and Mike is one of those persons. For the last 15 years, Mike's advised Regis, and he's no small part of us having 043s on our last three inspections. We're very happy about that. Want to make this a productive day. Mike's going to talk for an hour on data integrity. This is the number one way that companies find themselves in FDA warning letters. And actually, interesting in your presentation, you had some things where car companies have gotten some data integrity issues.
Oh, you wait.
You wait. Let's welcome up Mike Anisfeld.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning, everybody. Slight qualification. I am a QP in Europe, but because I'm resident here in the States, I'm on a reserve list in Europe. The day I move back and tell them I'm officially back in England, I become a full QP again. So that's the bizarrety of the European regulations. Today we're going to talk about data integrity, which is becoming the number one topic in FDA inspections. 3 weeks ago, I was in Seoul, Korea, with a client who's going through his fourth FDA inspection, so we expected no problem. One inspector for 5 days, 3 days spent doing data integrity, 2 days looking at the quality systems. Never got in production, never got into warehousing, never got into validation. It was all data integrity. So that's the move of FDA these days. We're living in a world of lots and lots of data and many words, and you hear about this all the time, big data, data integrity, and what does it really mean to us, and what does it really mean to society in general? So it's how do you access the data, who can change the data, how do you maintain the data? It's all part of that system. Just a bit of history, some Gmp trends. In the 1980s, we had basic Gmps. You know, the regulations came out and everybody was trying to get to grips with it. In the 1990s, we had the Part 11 computer controls. If you remember Y2K, anybody remember the panic of Y2K? Your bank accounts will disappear on midnight on December 31st, 1999. Some of you may be too young to remember that. Then we had the aughts, as they say, the 2000s, where we got into quality systems, out of specs, CAPAs, and trending, which was new to many, many companies. And now the theme of this last few years is data integrity. And as I said, it really is becoming the real focus of many inspections, not just FDA, the British, Swedish, other European countries are also very, very concerned about this. So it's becoming a global issue of really big proportions. Some quality management principles and where does this all fit together. If you read ICH, International Conference on Harmonization, they have guidelines which are now in effect basically worldwide. Everybody follows them. If you read ICH Q10, they talk about quality management systems, which involves the patient. What are we doing to impact the patient positively, I hope? How do we design our drugs and our APIs towards the patient? We talk about leadership and management responsibilities. Lewis's job here at Regis is to give the people the money, the finances, the time to get the job done. Then he delegates the quality aspects to Dan. He delegates the production aspects to somebody else. But management is the top key issue. The process, what is the process we're in? What are we trying to make? How are we trying to do it? And how do we design it that it's validated and foolproof? And then where is the evidence of that? Where is the data of that? And I've highlighted that because that's going to be the subject of today's discussion. Then we have CAPA, corrective action, preventive action. What do we do if things go wrong? Because none of you came to work this morning saying, I'm going to mess up. Things just happen. Well, you may do. I don't know. I hate the company. I'm going to really mess it up. But none of us really do that. But things happen. So what do we do? How do we correct? And then finally, we get into FDA's big one these days, which is their key to getting into data integrity, their key to getting into quality systems. They first go for the annual product reviews. So it's we give them the information and they can rip us apart. But that's the quality management principles. And you have to realize it's not just pharmaceuticals. I don't know if anybody's followed the news in the last few weeks about the scandal in Japan. Kobe Steel. Anybody heard of Kobe Steel? It hit NPR this morning for the first time. Kobe Steel makes the steel for automobile industry, and about 80% of all cars made in Japan use Kobe Steel. Well, it turns out that they've been fudging all their data about the steel strength. And now there's a huge scandal which could impact every car made in Japan over the last 10 years and could be massive, massive recalls. We're not sure yet what's going to be happening. So it's not just the pharmaceutical industry we worry about. It impacts everybody. It impacts everything. Mitsubishi Motors, another Japanese company, manipulated data to make the fuel economy for some of its cars look better. Hey, if Volkswagen does it, why don't we? I mean, hey, let's join the club. This one blows my mind. The US Air Force managed to lose 100,000 records in its database because they didn't do any backups. The US Air Force didn't do backups, lost 100,000 records? Doesn't that tell you something about government? Or in specifically, where was their QA people to make sure the system worked properly? So it's not just pharmaceuticals. This is an old one from pharmaceuticals from 2003, where this company called Pan Pharmaceuticals had to recall every product on the market because they had systematic and deliberate manipulation of their quality control test data. If they couldn't do the test, just write it a number. Makes no difference. Nobody's going to check. Well, guess what? They got caught out and caught out royalty. There was a period in 2004 that you could not get a vitamin product from Walgreens because everyone had been made in Australia and shipped over here, and it was a worldwide recall. Company went out of business about 6 months later. So it's everything. Now, it is a global concern. You want guidelines on data integrity? Well, there's one issued by the World Health Organization. The Pharmaceutical Inspection Cooperation Scheme, which is 50 countries, has a guideline, and it's identical word for word for the European Medical Agency. The British have come out with a great one, and FDA has come out with a guideline-ish. It doesn't exactly tell you what exactly to be done and how. If you really want to know what to do, read the British one. It's really the word for word tells you, no nonsense, what to do. So I'll give you that reference. All you have to do is Google MHRA Data Integrity Guideline. You get it. It's free.